丁拜尼，
晚上好。
晚上好。
嗯，
你回来吗？
准备肉一盘。啊，对，我今天回来了。
今天。
对，就是给他给我爸爸送到另一个医院去了，然后不需要，现在不需要陪护。然后去过去住一段时间看看情况再说。
在海州医院。
对对，现在可能我就照顾不了他了，就只能去交给医院去治疗。
OK
好，苏瑞肉一排不？
还有 Krishna。
还有不？可不？
我在，顶班的。
好。那好，那 good day， 我们可以开始了。
Hare Krishna。Om Magyanatimarandasya Gyananjana Shalakaya Chakshurunmilitanyena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Pristaya Bhutale Srimati Bhaktivedanta Swaminiti Namine。Namaste Saraswati Devi Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschacya Deshatarine Jaya Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Srivasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare Vanchakaupatarubhyascha Kripa-sindhubhayevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha. Alright, so we're going through sixth canto and we're on chapter 3. Yamaraj instructs his messengers.
我们现在学到的是《圣典摩迦王的第六篇的第三章，这一章是 Yamaraj 教导他的使者们。
So chapter begins with an inquiry from Maharaj Parikshit to Sukadeva Goswami.
这一章开头是以 Maharaj Parikshit Maharaj Parikshit 向 Sukadeva Goswami 的询问为开始的。
And he's asking him about how.It was very unusual for the order of Yamaraj not to be completed, wasn't followed. Yamaraj had ordered his servants to go and arrest Ajameel, but they had not been able to take Ajameel. They had been defeated by the Vishnu Dutas.
Maharaj Parikshit 就询问到，这是一件很不平常的事情。由于 Yamaraj 的命令在这个时候受到挫败了，怎么样挫败呢？就是 Yamaraj 命令 Yamaduta 去逮捕 Ajameela， 但是 Ajameela 不仅没有被逮捕，而且被 Vishnuduta 给拯救了。
So Maharaj Parikshit wants to know how did Yamaraj respond when he heard.That his servants, the Yamaduras, had not been successful in arresting Ajameela.
Maharaj Parikshit 就想问，当 Yamaraj 听到他的仆人去逮捕的时候没有成功的时候，他是怎么样回答这个事情的呢？
He said, "It never happened before that Yamaraj's order was not able to be carried out."
而且这样的事情从来以前就没有发生过，就是 Yamaraj 的命令并没有被执行成功。
So, Maharaj Parikshit asked Sukadeva Goswami to kindly explain to him why this happened.
Maharaj Parikshit 就希望 Sukadeva Goswami 给他解释一下为什么这个事情会发生呢？
So Sukadeva Goswami says, when the servants of Yamaraj were defeated by the servants of Lord Vishnu, they came back to Yamaraj to tell him.
Shukadeva Goswami 就跟 Maharaj Parikshit 说，当他们去逮捕这个活动失败了之后，他开始就回来告诉 Yamaraj。
So the Yamadutas told Lord Yamaraj that they asked Lord Yamaraj, how many controllers are there in this material world?
Yamaduta 就问 Yamaraj, 这个世界上到底有多少的控制者呢？
And how many causes are there for the different activities which people perform under the material nature?
在物质属性的影响和作用下，有多少原因对所从事的这些活动的结果负责呢？
So the Yamadutas were angry that they had been defeated by the Vishnu Dutas.
事实上 Yamaduta 他们非常生气，因为他们被Vishnu Dutta 所击败了，他们感觉到非常的生气。
And they want to understand, is there some other master beside their own master? Because they thought their master was the most powerful of all masters.
于是他们就很困惑，是否在他们的主人之外还有另外一个主人呢？而且他们，因为他们认为他们的主人 Yamaraj 本来就已经是有力量的主人了，他们非常的困惑。
So their thinking is, if we are the servants and we cannot carry out the order of our master without being defeated, then what's the point of us being his servants?
他们就觉得，如果一个作为他们的仆人不能战无不胜的履行指主人的命令的话，那么去服务这样一位无能的主人又有什么用呢？
It means that our master is not very powerful because he couldn't give us the ability to carry out his order.
这代表我们的主人并不是那么的有力量，因为我们无法非常完美，我们无法很顺利的履行他的命令。
So the Yamadutas say that if in this universe there are many different rulers, and then if they all disagree about punishment and reward, then it will be very difficult to organize this world.
Yamaduta 继续说道，如果在这个宇宙存在着各种各样的不同己见的惩罚者的话，那么对于统治管理这个世界也是非常困难。
The result will be nobody will be punished and no one will be rewarded, because whatever they do, it will be neutralized by other activities.
因为这样的情况下，那么没有人将会成为真正的惩罚者，也没有人将真正的被奖赏，既没有被奖赏，也没有被惩罚。因为他们的活动一旦接受惩罚或者得到奖赏，就会被其他的活动所中和掉。
Or, on the other hand, maybe everybody will have to be punished and rewarded.
另一种情况就是，有可能就是所有的人就既会受到惩罚，也会得到奖赏。
So because the Yamadutas had been defeated, they had some doubts now about Lord Yamaraj, who was their master.
因为 Yamaduta 已经被击败了，所以他这个时候对他们的主人 Yamaraj 感觉到非常的怀疑。
And they wonder, is Yamaraj, has he really got the power to punish the sinful people?
而且他们还怀疑，到底 Yamaraj 有没有得到力量去惩罚那些罪恶的人。
Because when they went to arrest Ajameel, there were some other people there, and they were coming on behalf of some other higher authority.
当他们去逮捕这个阿加密，抓这个阿加密勒的时候，有更高的权威阻止了他们。
So they don't know, is there only one authority or how many authorities are there?
到底是只有一个权威，还是说有其他的很多的权威的存在？
And if there are many authorities and they all have different opinions, then it will be a problem.
如果有很多个权威的存在，而且他们的观点都不一致的话，这将是一个问题。
Somebody may be wrongly punished, or somebody may be wrongly rewarded.
那么有可能有人被错误的惩罚，有可能有人就会被错误的奖赏。
Or he may not be punished or rewarded.
或者他既没有受到惩罚，也没有得到应得的奖赏。
So according to our experience, from what we've seen in our experience, if somebody is punished in one court, he can appeal to another court.
我们在这个世界上的经验也有存在，就是说有人如果他在一个法庭里上诉的话，他如果不服的话，也会去到另外一个法庭里面继续上诉。
So there may be different judgments.One judgment may punish him, another judgment may reward him.
有可能一个判决就会惩罚他，另外一个判决就会奖赏他。
But if we go to the court of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, there should not be any difference. Everybody should agree what should be the judgment.
但是作为至尊人格守神的法庭上就应该不应该有这种矛盾的或者说不一样的判决的存在。如果有人得到的判决，那应该必然是完美的，是正确的。
So the position of Yamaraj was very awkward in this case because of Ajamila.
Yamaraj 现在的这个处境非常的尴尬。因为阿加米勒的这个事件让 Yamaraj 的处境现在很尴尬。
The Yamaduras were right to try to arrest Ajamila.
Yamaduta 去抓捕阿加米勒是正确的。
But the Vishnuduras had stopped them.
但是 Vishnuduta 又阻止了他们。
So Yamaraj was accused by the Vishnuduras and the Yamaduras.
这个时候 Yamaraj 就被 Vishnuduta 和 Yamaduta 双方受到他们双方的责难。
Actually, Yamaraj is perfect in his judgment. He is empowered by Krishna to do this job, to punish the sinful people.
事实上 Yamaraj 是很完美的。他被 Krishna 赋予了力量去做这个工作，来惩罚那些罪恶的人。
So he's going to explain to his servants, the Yamaduras, he's going to explain to them about his real position and how everybody is controlled by Krishna.
Yamaraj 将会为他的这些使者们解释如何。至尊主是如何控制所有的一切都是如何在至尊主控制之下。
So the Yamaduras are still speaking to Yamaraj, and they said, there are many different karmis, many different workers.
Yamaduta 这个时候还继续说道，由于存在着各种各样的 karmi 和工作者。
And there may be different judges, and to give them justice, there may be different judges, different rulers.
因此也会有各种各样的对他们的判决。
But there has to be one supreme judge over all the judges.
在所有的判决之上，应该有一个至尊的判决控制者。
Just like in governments.There may be different departments and different officials.
就像这个政府部门，或许有各种不同的部门管理。
But the law has to be one.
但是，至尊是就是 最终的控制者是一个。
And that law must be for everyone. Must everybody's under the control of that law.
法律是一个，每一个人都在法律的控制之下。
So the Yamaduras, they could not understand how two different rulers, two different judges in the same case could have different opinions.
Yamadutta, 这个时候Yamadutta can't understand,
Yamaduras cannot understand how the two judges meaning the Vishnududas and the Yamaduras have different opinions. Yamaraj.
Yamadutta 这个时候不能理解，在 Vishnududutta 和 Yamaraj 之间，他们给出了不同的判断。
Yes, in this, it's the same case, the same circumstances, the same person, but they have different opinion.
这是同一个案子，但是呢，他们有不同的观点。
So the Yamaduras want to know who is the head judge, who's the chief of all the judges.
Yamadutta 就想知道谁到底是这个头呢？谁到底是掌管这个案子的这个上面的这个人呢？
And the Yamaduras, they knew Ajameya was a sinful person, and they knew Yamaraj wanted to punish him.
Yamadutta, 他知道阿加米勒是一个罪恶的人，而且他也知道 Yamaraj 想惩罚他。
But the Vishnududas, they wanted to excuse him, they wanted to forgive him. So this was a puzzle for the Yamaduras.
但是 Vishnududutta 解救了他，赦免了他，原谅了他。所以这个情况对于，就是一个很难办的事情，令人费解的事情。
There must only be one supreme judge. Cannot be many supreme judges. There may be many judges, but one supreme judge over all of them.
过去有很多不同的判断和不同的这个处决，但是至尊的处决一定是只有一个。
So the Yamaduras tell Yamaraj that we thought you were that supreme judge.
Yamadutta 就告诉 Yamaraj, 你是那一个至尊的法官。
And we thought that you have control even over the demigods.
而且我们知道你甚至控制着半神。
We thought you were the master of all the living entities.
在我们看来，您是所有众生的主人。
And you know who's pious and who's sinful.
您知道谁是虔诚的，谁是罪恶的。
But now, we see that your authority is not so powerful.
但是现在我们看来呢，您的权威不是那么的有力量。
Because these four.Vishnududas were very wonderful, perfect. They stopped your order from going through.
因为这四个非常美丽的 Vishnududas, 他们阻止了您的命令的执行。
So the Yamaduras, they thought that Yamaraj was the only person in charge of punishing the sinful people.
Yamadutta 认为 Yamaraj 是唯一一个可以主持和惩罚罪恶之人。
They were sure that no person could stop his judgment.
他们非常确信没有人可以阻止他们的判决。
But now they've seen these four people from Vishnu come and they've stopped the order of Yamaraj.
但是他们现在看到了这个四个来自威士奴那里的人阻止了 Yamaraj 的这个命令。
So the Yamaduras said, we were bringing this sinful Ajameya to the hellish planets.
Yamadutta 说我们正在把这个阿加米勒罪恶的人带到地狱里去。
This was your order. We were following your order.
这是你的命令，我们正在执行着你的命令。
But then these very beautiful people from Siddhaloka, they came and they cut the ropes that we had used to tie up Ajamila.
但是这四个非常漂亮的来自西塔洛卡的人，他们来阻止，而且剪断了我们逮捕阿加米勒的这个绳子。
Actually, the Yamaduras, they wanted to bring the Vishnu Duras in front of Yamaraj.
事实上，亚玛都塔甚至都想把维什努都塔给抓捕到 Yamaraj 的面前。
And then if the Yamaduras saw that the Vishnu Duras were punished by Yamaraj, then they would be happy.
他们觉得，如果他们能看到 Vishnu Duta 被 Yamaraj 所惩罚，他们才会感觉到高兴。
Of course, it never happened. The Vishnu Duras, they didn't go to Yamaraj. They didn't go to see Yamaraj.
但是当然，这样的事情没有发生。Vishnu Duta 他们并没有去到 Yamaraj 那里去，他们也没有去见 Yamaraj。
So the Yamaduras described to Yamaraj, they told him that when the sinful Ajamil, he started to chant the name of Narayan. And at that time, these four men came and they freed him. And they told him, don't be afraid, don't be afraid, we will protect you.
Vishnu Duta, Yamaduta 就跟 Yamaraj 说道，当这个罪恶的人阿迦弥勒一喊出 Narayana 的名字的时候，这四个 Vishnu Duta 就立刻出现在他们的面前，而且安抚了阿迦弥勒，告诉他不要害怕，不要害怕。
So the Yamadutas told Yamaraj that we want to know who are these four men, who are these people, that can you tell us about them?
亚玛都塔就问这个亚玛拉吉，说他希望从亚玛拉吉那里了解到这四个人到底是谁，他们来自于哪里。
The Yamaduras, they're even thinking about committing suicide because they couldn't be successful in carrying out the order of their master.
这个亚玛都塔甚至都想到了要去自杀，因为他们无法很顺利的与执行他们的主人的命令。
But first they want to know about who these four men are, the Vishnu Duras, who are they?
但是在这之前，他们想了解这四个人到底是谁，他们来自哪。
So they know Yamaraj can tell them because Yamaraj, he knows everything.
他们知道 Yamaraj 能告诉他，因为他们知道 Yamaraj 知道一切。
So Lord Yamaraj, when he heard this question from his servants, he was very pleased with them.
当 Yamaraj 听到他的仆人问这样的问题的时候，他非常的高兴。
He was very pleased with them because he heard them chant the holy name of Narayan.
他之所以对他们非常的满意，因为他听到了他的这些仆人唱诵了 Narayana 的圣名。
And so he, by hearing the holy name of Narayan, he remembered the lotus feet of the Lord.
通过聆听了 Narayana 的圣名，他记忆着主的莲花足。
So Yamaraj is, he's the controller of living entities. He's actually in charge of their pious and sinful activities.
Yamaraj 管理着虔诚和不虔诚的生物体。
So he was very happy to hear his servants chant the holy name of Lord Narayan.
他非常满意于他的仆人唱诵了至尊主的圣名 Narayana 的圣名。
Because usually all Yamaraj has to do is punish the sinful people, and they never chant the name of Narayan.
通常情况下，他们总是惩罚一些罪恶的人，而且他们从来没有唱诵过 Narayana 的圣名。
So when his servants chanted the name, then he was very pleased because Yamaraj is also a devotee. He's a Vaishnava.
因此当他的仆人唱诵了主那儿样子的圣名的时候，那 Yamaraj 非常的开心，因为 Yamaraj 他也是一位奉献者。
So Yamaraj told his servants that you think that I am the supreme, but actually I'm not the supreme. There's somebody above me, and not only is he above me, he's above all the demigods.
Yamaraj 说道，你们把我接受为至尊，实际上我不是至尊，在我之上，而且在包括在所有的半世人之上，有一个至尊的存在。
He's above all the gods like Indra and Chandra, and he's the one supreme master. He's the one supreme controller.
在所有的半世人，包括 Indra、Chandra 之上，有一位至尊人控制者。
And there's a partial manifestation of this person in the form of Brahma, Vishnu, and Shiva.
他的人格部分的扩展是 Brahma.Vishnu or Shiva.
Brahma, Vishnu and Shiva are in charge of the creation, maintenance and destruction of the universe.
Brahma, Vishnu, Shiva, 他们分别创造、维系和毁灭这个宇宙。
And the whole world is controlled by him. Just like a bull is controlled by a rope in its nose.
就像一头公牛被他鼻子中的这个绳子所控制一样，这一位至尊者他控制着整个宇宙。
Yeah, sometimes we see a big bull, and the little boy will be holding the rope. There's a rope put through the nose of the bull, and the little boy he's holding the rope, and he can control the bull because the rope has gone through his nose.
只要这个公牛的鼻子里面有一颗绳子。一个小男孩就可以控制这个公牛。
Sometimes they say that if you have trouble with your wife, if she's not obedient, then you get her a nose ring, and then you can control her.
有这么一个说法，就是说，如果你的妻子并不是那么容易的控制，那就让你的妻子也去打一个鼻环，你也能控制你的妻子。
So the ardor carriers of Yamaraj, they thought there must be some ruler above Yamaraj. They were thinking there must be somebody else above Yamaraj.
Yamaraj 的执行官怀疑在 Yamaraj 之上有一位统治者。
So Yamaraj told them, yes, there is. There's one controller above everyone.
Yamaraj 回答道，是的，确实是的。而且是在所有的生物，在每一个人之上，在所有的万事万物之上，有一位至尊控制者。
Yamaraj is in charge of some of the moving living entities, like the human beings, but not the animals.
Yamaraj 他管理着一些能动的生物体，比如说人类，但是动物并不在他的管理之下。
Only human beings have.Consciousness to understand this is right and this is wrong.
只有人类他可以判断这是正确的还是错误的，他有这种知觉可以判断。
So the ones who do the sinful activities, they come under the control of Yamaraj.
那些从事罪恶活动的人处在 Yamaraj 的控制之下。
So Yamaraj is not the supreme controller, he's only a department controller.
Yamaraj 他不是至尊的控制者，他是一部分的控制者。
There are other demigods who control other departments.
还有其他的半世人，他们是其他部门的控制者。
And above all of them, there's one supreme controller.
在他们所有人之上，有一位至尊的控制者。
And others.Other demigods, they control their own departments.
其他的半世人，他们控制着他们的各自的部门。
They're not very important in comparison to Lord Krishna, who is the supreme controller.
但是他们无法跟至尊主 Krishna 的控制的这个能力或者说 相比。
Okay, so the Yamadutas say, Yamaraj is saying, Lord Yamaraj is speaking, just like the driver of a bullock cart puts a rope through the nose of the bull to control them, the same way the Krishna binds all men through the ropes of his words.
就像牛车夫用绳子控着这个牛，以驾驭这个牛车一样，至尊人格首神 Krishna 用他的语言话语控制着所有人。
And his words are there in the Vedas, which describe his different names and activities.
他的话语在伟达经中阐明了社会四阶层。阐释了不同的这个阶层的名称以及不同的活动。
And out of fear of his orders, all the different people in the different varnas and ashrams, they all worship the Supreme Lord.
所有这些阶层和不同阶段的所有这些人，他们都崇拜至尊主。
And they worship him according to their capacity, according to their activities.
他们根据他们各自的活动去崇拜至尊主。
So material world, we can understand everyone is conditioned. Doesn't matter who they are. You may be a human being, you may be a human being, or a demigod, or an animal, or a plant. But we're conditioned.
在物质世界之中，每一个人都是受，每一个生物都是受条件限制的，无论他是一个人，还是半神人，还是动物，还是这些植物，所有人都是受自然受限制的。
We're controlled by the material nature, by the material nature, and behind the material nature is Krishna.
我们被物质自然所控制，而物质自然的背后是至尊人格首神。
Bhagavad Gita says like that. Bhagavad Gita, 9th chapter. Material nature is moving under my direction, Krishna says.
主 Krishna 在国家梵歌中说，物质自然是在我的指导下工作。
So Krishna's behind the material nature.
Krishna 在物质自然的背后。
So apart from other living entities, the human being is controlled by, we're meant to be controlled by the Vedic injunctions.
与其他生物不同的是，人类是是被伟达训谕所系统的控制。
And then the instructions of the Vedas will be different according to a different varna and ashrams.
伟达训谕根据人们，就是说，在不同的 varna 和不同的 ashram 之中，有他们人类会遵循不同的这个原则和规范。
If we don't follow the rules and regulations of our varna and ashram, then we get punished by Yamaraj.
如果我们不遵守我们 varna 和 ashram 的规范和原则，我们就会被 Yamaraj 所惩罚。
So every human being is supposed to come to the position of a brahmana.
因此每一个人都应该提升到 brahmana 婆罗门的这个层面。
And then from that point, then he should go on to become a Vaishnava.
从 brahmana 的层面，一个人应该从那里成为一位 Vaishnava.
So this is how you get perfection in life.
这是我们获得人生完美的。
It doesn't matter if you're a Brahmana, a Kshatriya, Vaishya, or Sudra, we can elevate ourselves by worshipping the Supreme Lord.
无论我们是 Brahmana, Vaishya, 还是 Sudra, 还是 Vaishya, 我们都可以崇拜至尊主。
And the different positions, the different ashrams and varnas, they help us to do proper duties for the pleasure of the Lord.
我们在不同的 Varna 和 Ashram 里面，我们做着各自不同的职责，是取悦主。
Everyone is supposed to worship the Supreme Lord.
每一个人都应当去崇拜至尊主。
The Supreme Lord is everywhere and in everything.
至尊主在每一个地方，每一件事情之中。
So if we worship the Lord according to our ability, then our life will be perfect.
如果我们根据我们的能力去崇拜至尊主的话，我们的人生将会完美。
The perfection of life is to worship the Supreme Lord according to our different ashram and varna, according to our position in society.
根据在这个社会中我们得到的不同的 varna, ashram, 我们去崇拜主而获得人生的完美。
So by following the varna ashram, then we can go back to Godhead.
通过遵循 Varna 和 Ashram 的制度，我们可以回归守神。
Every Varna and every Ashram, the purpose is to please the Supreme Lord.
任何，就是说每一个 Varna 和每一个 Ashram, 他们的目的都是为了去取悦主。
And we have to, of course, take direction under the guidance of the spiritual teacher.
当然我们要在一位真正的灵性导师的指导下去做这些活动，去取悦主。
So everyone should worship him either directly or indirectly.
每一个人都在直接或间接的去崇拜他。
If we worship him directly, then we get liberation quickly.
如果我们直接的去崇拜至尊主的话，我们会很快的得到结果。
But if we worship him indirectly, then it will take longer time.
而如果我们间接的去服务至尊主的话，我们会花更多的时间。
So the Vedas give instructions for everyone according to their different positions in the varnas and ashrams.
维达经根据人们所处的不同的 varna 和 ashram 给予不同的训示。
So everyone's supposed to follow, worship the Lord and offer obeisances to Him and do our duty according to the Vedas.
每一个人都应该顶拜至尊主，而且遵循伟大经所给予每一个人所特定固定的这些不同的职责。
So then, Lord Yamaraj mentions the names of other great demigods.
Yamaraj 就在这里又提到了其他的一些半神的名字。
He says, first of all, he himself, Yamaraj, then Indra, the king of heaven.
首先是他自己 Yamaraj, 然后是天堂国王 Indra.
Then Niriti, who is also Niriti, he is.Anyway, he's a demigod.
还有半神 Niriti.
And then Varuna, who's the god of the sea. Chandra, the moon god. Agni, the fire god.
水神 Varuna, 月神 Chandra, Agni, 火神。
And then Lord Shiva and Pavana.
主 Shiva, Pavana.
Lord Brahma, Surya is the sun god.And Vishnu,
主 Brahma, 还有太阳神 Surya, 还有
Abhusha Vishnu is Vishvasu,
Vishvasu,
and then the eight Vasus, and the Sadhyas, the Maruts, the Rudras, the Siddhas, the Marit and Marichi, and the other great Rishis, they all engage to help to maintain the affairs of the universe.
八位 Vasu, Sadhya, Marat, Rudra, Siddhaha, Marichi, 还有其他掌管宇宙各部门的所有的这些圣人们，他们都在协助着处理了这些宇宙各部门的事物。
And then there's the best of the demigods, Brihaspati, and the great sages headed by Bhrigu, and they're all freed from the influence of passion and ignorance.
还有半世人之中的佼佼者 Brihaspati， 还有以 Brigu 为首的这些圣人们，他们都不受物质的激情和愚昧属性的影响，他们不被激情和愚昧属性影响。
So although we're in the mode of goodness, although we're in the mode of goodness, still we cannot understand the supreme personality of Godhead.
即便我们都处在善良属性之中，我们仍然不能理解至尊人格首身的活动。
So people who are in illusion, they can.There's no way they can ever understand the Lord.
因此，那些处在幻象之下、处在愚昧属性之下控制着的人，他们怎么可能去理解至尊主？
Hare Krishna. So.So everybody's controlled by the three modes of nature.
所有人都在物质属性的三属性之下控制。
And you've got the people who are controlled by passion and ignorance. For people who are controlled by passion and ignorance, they can never understand God.
那些处在激情和愚昧控制之下的人，他们根本无法了解神。
And even people in the mode of goodness, like the demigods and great rishis, names we mentioned just now, they cannot understand the activities of the Supreme Lord.
而且我们这里提到的这些所有的圣人们、半圣人们，他们即便处在善良属性层面下，也不能够明白至尊人格首身的活动。
But if somebody...It says in the Bhagavad Gita, if we do devotional service, then that's transcendental to the material nature. Therefore, then the Lord says, by devotion he can be understood.
但是那些奉献者、从事者、超然的奉献服务的人，在《薄伽梵歌》中说，做奉献服务的人超越于所有的这些品质。他通过奉献服务可以了解他，通过奉献者可以了解他本人。
Only the devotees, because devotees are transcendental to the material nature, so they can understand the Lord.
只有奉献者可以了解主，因为奉献者超越物质的品质，物质自然属性。
So, Bhishma Dev, when he was laying on the bed of arrows, he told Maharaj Yudhisthira like that.
当 Bhishma Deva 躺在箭床上给 Maharaj Yudhisthira 说的时候，也说了这么样。
He told him, nobody can know what is the plan of Lord Krishna.
他说，没有人可以知道至尊计划。
Even they may be great philosophers, and they may ask everybody, may try to understand, but they get bewildered.
即便是最伟大的哲学家，他们煞费苦心地去寻找。到头来也无法了解至尊。
We cannot understand by speculation.
我们无法通过心智推敲。
But by devotion we can understand the Lord.
我们无法通过心智推敲去理解主，只有通过奉献服务可以理解主。
There may be thousands of people who are all trying for perfection.
或许有千万之人，他们在寻求完美。
But those who have achieved perfection, only one may be able to understand the Lord.
在那些达到完美的人之中，只有一个，他们或许是通过奉献服务之途了解 Krishna.
So Lord Yamaraj gives an example. He said, just like the different parts, the limbs of our body, they cannot see the eyes.
Yamaraj 在这里举了一个例子，就像我们身体的四肢，他们看不到眼睛。
In the same way, the living entities, we cannot see the Lord, although He's the super soul in everyone's heart, we cannot see Him.
而且就正如同这样，我们 我们同样的，我们生物体也看不到以超灵的形式居于我们内心之中的至尊主。
But we cannot understand the Lord by our senses, or by our mind, or by the life air, or the thoughts within our heart. Can't use these things to understand the Lord.
我们无法通过感官、心意、生命之气、我们的想法、我们的言语等等，我们无法探，我们无法探知到至尊主。
So the eyes, they direct the movements of the different parts of our body.
我们的眼睛是帮助我们的身体去提供方向的，指导我们方向去移动的。
Just like our legs move forward because the eyes see what is in front of them.
就像我们的脚是往前走，因为我们的眼睛是往前看的。
And the hand touches because the eye see things to touch.
我们的手之所以去触摸，是因为我们的眼睛所看到的那个对象。
So everybody acts under the direction of the super soul who's in everybody's heart.
同样的，每一个生物体都在至尊主以超灵的形式居于内心的这个超灵，在他的指导下去。
Right, Krishna says that from me comes knowledge, remembrance, and forgetfulness.
至尊主在《薄伽梵歌》中说，由我记忆、知识和遗忘而产生。
So that Krishna is talking about his expansion as the super soul.
Krishna 讲述了他以超灵的扩展。
And then again, Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita that he is.In the hearts of everyone, directing their wanderings, directing the movements of everybody from the heart.
接着，至尊主在《薄伽梵歌》中也说，他在人的内心指导着人的愿望，指导着人的活动。
So without the super soul, we cannot do anything.
因此，没有超灵的话，我们无法做任何事情。
The super soul is acting.All the time, but we cannot understand this acting.
超灵在任何时候都在活动，但是我们无法理解它。
Just like we said, the eyes, we can't understand the eyes. We can't see the eyes with our legs or with our hands. You can only see things with the eyes. We cannot see the eyes.
我们可以用眼睛去看，但是我们的身体却无法看到我们的眼睛。
If when we see, then we walk forward. If our legs could see, we wouldn't need to use our eyes. But we cannot see without the eyes. It's not possible.
如果我们的腿它能够看的话，它就不用这个眼睛了。但是这是不可能的。
We cannot see the super soul in our heart.
同样的，我们也无法看到我们内心的超灵。
But we need the direction of the super soul.
但是我们又需要超灵的指导。
So the Lord in the heart, the super soul, the supreme personality of Godhead, he is fully self-sufficient and independent. He's the master of everyone and everything.
至尊主是一切万物的主人，他完全独立又自给自足。
And he has his own form and qualities and features.
他有他自己的形体、品质和特征。
And he has his servants, the Vaishnavas. They're very beautiful and they possess the bodily features just like him.
而且他有他的仆人。他的那些奉献者几乎有他一样的品质和特征。
Yeah, they have his qualities, they have his nature, and they're always wandering within this world. They go everywhere.
他们有他的一样的品质和特征，而且经常自由地在这个物质世界，在这个世界漫游。
So Yamaraj was describing about the Supreme Lord.But his servants, the Yamadutas, they wanted to know about the Vishnu Dutas.
Yamaraj 在这里在描述至尊主，但是呢 Yamaduta 他们却想知道为什么 Duta。
Because the Vishnu Dutas had defeated them.
因为 Vishnu Duta 击败了 Yamaduta。
So Yamaraj told them that the Vishnu Dutas, they resemble the Supreme Lord. They look just like him. They have the same qualities, the same nature.
于是 Yamaraj 就说 Vishnu Duta 拥有与至尊人格守神至尊主一样的身体特征、品质和本性。
So the Vishnu Dutas or the Vaishnavas, they're almost as qualified as the Supreme Lord.
也就是说 Vishnu Duta 或 Vaishnava 的品质几乎与至尊主是一样的。
The Yamadutas were told that the Vishnu Dutas are just as powerful as the Supreme Lord.
Vishnu Yamaduta 被告知 Vishnu Duta 的力量不少于 Vishnu.
Vishnu is above Yamaraj. He's more powerful than Yamaraj. And the Vishnu Dutas are also above the Yamadutas. They're above the Yamadutas.Right?
因为 Vishnu 主 Vishnu 在 Yamaraj 之上，所以呢 Vishnu Duta 也在 Yamaduta 之上。
So if somebody is protected by the Vishnu Dutas, the Yamadutas cannot possibly harm him.
因此如果有人被 Vishnu Duta 所保护，那么 Yamaduta 也无法去触碰。
So these order carries of Lord Vishnu, they are worshipped even by the demigods.
这些主威士奴的执行官甚至受到半神人们的崇拜。
But it's very rare that people get to see them.
但是呢，人们非常罕有才能见，就是非常少的情况下才能见到他。
But the Vishnu Dutas, they will protect the devotees from their enemies.
但是威士努都塔保护主的奉献者免受敌人。
And they will protect the devotees from going to Yamaraj as well.
而且他们保护奉献者免于去到 Yamaraj 那里去。
And they will protect them from natural disturbances also.
而且他还保护威士努都塔还保护奉献者免于自然的攻击。
So he, Yamaraj wants to tell the Yamadutas not to be envious of the Vishnu Dutas.
Yamaraj 在这里告诉 Vishnu, 告诉 Yamaduta, 不要对于 Vishnu Duta 感觉到很嫉妒。
The Yamadutas, Yamaraj told the Yamadutas that these Vishnu Dutas, you have to respect them, offer obeisance. Even the demigods offer obeisance to them.
Yamaraj 告诉 Yamaduta, 这些 Vishnu Duta 甚至受到半世人的崇拜，我们应该尊敬他，即使是半世人都在崇拜他们。
Because these Vishnu Dutas, they're always careful, they want to protect the devotees. They protect the devotees from any danger, from natural disturbances or from their enemies. The Vishnu Dutas will come and protect the devotee.
Vishnu Duta, 因为他们总是保护着奉献者免受敌人、自然灾害等等这些危险。
So Prabhupada explains, like sometimes we are worried, devotees are worried that what will happen if there's a war?
圣帕帕德在这里解释到，因为当时有奉献者就担心，要是来了世界大战怎么办？
But Prabhupada said, devotees should be confident that will be protected by the Vishnu Dutas or by Krishna himself.
圣帕帕德就说，奉献者应该自信，我们是被 Vishnu Duta 或者主 Krishna 至尊主直接保护。
For devotees, there's no material danger.
对于奉献者来说，没有物质的危险。
In the material world, there's danger for everybody, every step, but not for devotees.
在物质世界，每一步都存在着危险，但是这不是对奉献者。
But devotee means we're surrendered fully to the lotus feet of Krishna.
但是奉献者意味着他是完全臣服 Krishna 的人。
So devotee should be, we should always know that we will be protected by Krishna or Vishnu Dudas or Lord Vishnu. As long as we are in this material world, we should be engaged in devotional service.
奉献者总是明白他被主 Vishnu Dutta 或者主 Vishnu 保护，只要我们还在这个物质世界里，我们。As long as we are in this material world,
yeah, we have to do devotional service.
只要我们还在这个物质世界里，我们就应该一直做奉献服务。
And that means preaching the Lord Chaitanya's message.
做奉献服务意味着就去传播主 Chaitanya 的教导。
Or chanting Hare Krishna mantra, doing Sankirtan.
唱诵 Hare Krishna mantra.然后呢，做齐颂圣名的运动
，spreading Krishna consciousness everywhere，
在每一个地方传播 Krishna 知觉。
Okay.
Okay.
So we will stop here today. Are there any questions?
Yes. First question from Chandra Vinasir Manaji.虔诚的顶拜咕噜顶拜翻译请教咕噜主 Krishna 在国家梵歌里说快乐和痛苦好比季节一样不请自来那么也是不用努力面对快乐和痛苦的感受快乐和痛苦自动会消失这样理解对吗以前听说过当一个人在享受的时候是在消费好的业报痛苦的时候是在净化坏的业报那么这个快乐和痛苦的感受自动来去消失的时候业报也是否随着快乐和痛苦一起消失呢还是快乐痛苦的感受消失但是业报还是累计积到自己的账户上去呢感谢你 Obeisances to Gurudev And I want to ask, the Lord Krishna said in Bhagavad Gita, the happiness and some sufferings, like the season changes, they will come and they will ultimately come. So if that means the, we don't try very hard and we don't need to try hard to face this happiness and sufferings. And the happiness and sufferings, they will ultimately disappear. Is that right? Understanding?
Yes, that's right. Understanding.
是的，这是一种正确的理解。
Happiness will come on its own, just like distress comes. Nobody wants distress, but distress comes anyway.
快乐和痛苦他们都会独自来我们都不想要痛苦但是痛苦还是会来
So we know that distress is going to come the same way happiness will also come without our trying for it
我们知道痛苦它会不请自来快乐也会不请自来
What we need to do is to try to please Krishna work for Krishna
我们所需要做的是去取悦 Krishna
then everything will come
这样一切都会来
there may be some
yes.
happiness there may be some distress but devotee is not attached to the results
或许会有一些快乐或许也会有一些痛苦但是奉献者并不依附
a devotee is attached to service he just simply wants to serve Krishna
奉献者所依附的是服务，他只想去服务 Krishna。
We may get good result, we may not get good result, but What's important is we try to do some service for Krishna.
有一些我们或许会得到这个结果，有一些我们或许得不到，但是我们想要做的去服务，想要做的是去服务 Krishna. Then she asked, what I heard about before, when somebody is enjoying, is like to, let me check.When somebody enjoying is also enjoying his good karma, and also the suffering, when somebody is suffering, is also purifying his bad karma. So, So when the happiness and suffering disappear, our karma is also disappear at that time.
Yes, definitely.
是的。
But you have to remember, we have a lot of karma.
是的，但是我们有很多的 karma, 我们有很多的业报。
We're using up some of it.
我们耗尽了一些的业报。
But we have a mountain of karma from the past.
但是我们过去有不计其数的业报。
So, we don't think you get free of all your karma just by suffering or just by enjoying good results. That's not going to end the karma.
不要想着遭受一些痛苦就会让你的业报得到结束。
We have to surrender to Krishna, then we get free of karma.
我们需要的是臣服于主 Krishna, 这样才能免于业报。
Then we can overcome all the karma. We just take shelter of Krishna.
这样我们可以克服，我们只需要脱避于主 Krishna.
Yes.
Yes. Next question from 真真。Hare Krishna, 顶拜 Gurudev, 顶拜您的莲花子，顶拜翻译和主持人和所有奉献者。经常听到三重苦，三重苦指的是什么 ？Hare Krishna, obeisance to Gurudev. I always heard about different sufferings. What these three sufferings?
This is called, first one is miseries due to material nature.
这是由于物质属性带来的痛苦
，like too hot or too cold or earthquake or typhoon or tsunami。
一种是物质自然带来的痛苦，比如说台风、地震等等这种物质自然给我们带来的痛苦。
Then we have miseries from other living entities.
第二重苦是由其他的生物体给我们带来的痛苦。
Sometimes maybe the people in your work, maybe your boss is not very nice, or maybe it's some problem at home, maybe your husband or your children are a problem, or maybe some mosquito or some dog giving you trouble.
比如说我们在工作上所受的苦。在工作上，我们的上司给我们带来的痛苦；在家庭之中，我们的家人给我们带来的痛苦；或者说，其他的一些微小的生物体，像蚊子啊、狗啊，还有其他的一些生物体给我们带来的痛苦。
And then the third kind of suffering is due to our own body and mind, just like headache, toothache, backache, legache.
第三种痛苦是我们的躯体和心意给我们带来的痛苦，比如说我们头疼、背疼、脚疼等等各种各样的疼痛。
So these are the three miseries. In Sanskrit, they're called adi-daivik, adi-bhautik, and adi-atmik.
这三种痛苦在梵文上 adi-daivik, adi-bhautik, adi
Atmic.
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 So, yeah, there's suffering. These are the three kinds of suffering in the material world. Because we're under the modes of nature, under the three modes of nature, so we meet with a lot of suffering.
Next question from Amy. 顶拜亲爱的姑姑的莲花族，顶拜翻译发布。替一位新朋友问：若以吠陀的仪轨婚姻的伴侣，若以吠陀的仪轨结婚的伴侣，在任何情况下，是否今生直到命中，婚姻关系都成立 ？A basis to dear Gurudev's lotus feet and.This question for a new devotee, I represent a new people ask. If someone get, some couple get married by the Vedic culture, and I want to ask in any condition, until to the death, this marriage relationship are still there?
What? This marriage relationship?
Still exist, 是否都成立，都存在。
What, after death?
No, he didn't mention the death. He just means
Dao,
for this lifetime,
Dao Si Wang.
This marriage,
to death.
Before death, this, all the, this kind of marriage relationship is all still...exist.
Yes, definitely. Lifetime relationship.
I think she wants to ask whether they are divorced.
Oh, if they're divorced.
Whether they are divorced, yeah, this kind of relationship is still...
No, there's no divorce in Krishna. In this kind of marriage, divorce is not allowed.
在如果是以伟达的这个仪轨结婚的话，仪式结婚的话，离婚是不被允许的。
This is lifetime marriage.
这是一生的结婚，一生的婚姻。
Lifetime companions.
一生的伴侣。
You cannot.Don't think that, if I don't get along, if we don't like each other, we'll just divorce. That's not the proper way. Marriage is for life. Till death do us part.We say, that's the Christian saying, they say, until death do us part. Until we'll be together until we die.
在我直到死我们都在一起。
So that is the concept.
这是我们的概念。
But, of course, after Grihastha life, you move into Vanaprastha life.Vanaprastha life means retired life.
但是呢，在居士生活结束之后，你应该移动到，就是说进入到下一个阶层，居士阶层叫到下一个阶层 Vanaprastha.
Vanaprastha means retired life.
Vanaprastha 的生活意味着退休的生活。
It means you give up the material work and you prepare for the next life.
这意味着我们放弃物质的工作，为下一世做准备。
So you stay with the wife, the husband and wife stay together, and they may do things like they may go to visit holy places, or they may just simply stay at home, but the center of their activities is devotional service.
他们或许就是说， 这一对夫妻他们还在一起，但是呢他们的工作的中心是奉献服务，他们或者也可以去到圣地。
Yeah, because they're getting old, so retirement means after the age of 50, then they should move into the third ashram, Vanaprastha. And that means you prepare for the next life.
在差不多50岁的时候，我们就已经年老了，在那个时候我们就退休，进入到下一个生命的阶段 ,Vanaprastha, 新高僧的这个阶段。
The point is it takes time to forget.About all of our attachments in the material life. You know, married life, you have children and you have a lot of things. But then, you know, when we retire, then you have to put all of these things aside and we have to forget them.
这个阶段的要点是我们得忘掉我们的物质的各种各样的依附。因为在我们结婚的时候我们有家庭我们有孩子我们有各种各样的工作但是到了这个阶段 Vanaprastha 50岁退休的这个阶段的时候我们得忘记这些衣服
So that is successful marriage when as you get older you move into the third stage the Vanaprastha ashram and you prepare for the next life
这个是很成功的successful marriage, 这个是很成功的婚姻。当你到了一定年龄的时候，你去到下一个生命的阶段。
And you and the husband and wife together, they both do spiritual practice. The wife stays with the husband, but there's no intimacy anymore. They're old now. They're not going to have more children, but the consciousness is more on.Doing devotional service.
而且他们没有这种很亲密的接触，到了，因为到了那个年龄的时候，他们都很老了，不应该再去想着要去要小孩。他们应该更多的是 Krishna 的知觉。
And if possible, you try to come to the holy dham and spend time in the holy dham, visiting holy places.
如果可以的话，应该更多的拜访圣地，居住在圣地。
We were very fortunate that we were able to visit some holy places a few years ago.
我们非常幸运在几年之前我们拜访过一些圣地。
We traveled with the devotees to visit different places. We went to Hardwar, Rishikesh, and Benares.
我们和一些奉献者去旅行，去了哈德瓦、贝纳勒斯、
Varanasi，
Rishikesh， 还有瓦尔纳西。
And we went to Naimisharanya， and we went to Triveni， where the Ganga meets the Yamuna。
我们还去了南米舍尔亚森林，还去了 Trimini， 就是亚穆纳河和冈冈汇合的地方。
And we went to Kurukshetra.
我们去了库尔之野。
So it was very relishable to visit all these holy places.
拜访这些圣地，就是有一种很有滋味。
And we have the memories of all of these places with us. We watched the devotees, we would go in the evening to see how they worship Mother Ganga. And of course we went to Vrindavan.And we visited Vrindavan and Govardhan and Radhakund.
当然我们还去了 Vrindavan, 去了 Govardhan 山还去了 Radhakund.
Nandagram. So it's so nice to visit the holy places and see the temples and see the deities, chant the holy name.
去拜访这些圣地。去各种不同的庙宇，去见这些奉献者，唱诵圣名，这些都是非常好的。
So Vanaprastha life is meant for that, that we get detached from the home and we go to visit this, we take shelter of the spiritual atmosphere of the holy Dham.
Vanaprastha
we take shelter of the holy places. We get freed from the material entanglement of all the attachments of the material world, and we take shelter of the holy places.
Vanaprastha 就是我们尽量居住在圣地的话，我们脱避于圣地，脱避于这种各种不同的这些圣地。
And we'll hear Ajamil, he did the same thing. Ajamila, he did the same thing.
我们将会听到阿加米勒他也做了同样的事情。
Yeah, after he saw the Yamadutas and he heard how the Vishnu Dutas spoke to them, then he left the home, he left everybody, he left his family, he left that woman, and he went to Benares.
当阿加米勒听到维什努都塔和亚玛都塔的这个谈话之后，他也开始准备想做一个纯粹奉献者。他离开了家庭，离开了他的女人，然后去到了贝南的，
no,
去到了 Hardwar,
he went to Hardwar, yeah. And he was able to give up his body on the bank of the Ganga.
他在恒河的岸边准备离开他的躯体。
Just like Pankajangari Prabhu, Pankajangari Prabhu, he was, you know, he was not well and they took him to Calcutta and he was in the hospital in Calcutta. But then he said, take me back to Mayapur. So he came back to Mayapur and then he gave up his body in Mayapur.
就像我们熟知的 Pankajangari Prabhu, 他因为身体不好所以 去到了加尔各答。在加尔各答医院待了一段时间之后呢，他说请把我带回到玛雅普，然后他在玛雅普离开了躯体。
So Mayapur is right on the bank of the Ganga. It's a holy place, very nice place to depart from the body.
玛雅普也在恒河的岸边，所以也是一个离开躯体的一个很好的地方。
Even we cannot be in Mayapur to leave the body, we want to be with devotees when we leave the body.
即便我们不能在玛雅普离开躯体，我们也希望能在能有奉献者的陪伴下离开躯体。
Because devotees can chant the holy name for us when we leave the body, as we leave the body, they will chant the holy name and help us to remember Krishna.
因为当我们离开躯体的时候，奉献者可以在我们身边唱诵圣名，唱诵 Hare Krishna。
Okay, any other question?
Yes, this Amy asked for the new people. These new people have another question. How the Bhakti Yoga see these couples they together for one night?
I'm sorry, I don't understand. What's the question?
What's if the two people their marriage life is one lifetime they didn't divorce, how we see them? What are our comments or attitude?
What is our comment or attitude?
Yeah, for this kind of people they didn't divorce, they get together for one lifetime and good couple.
Well, it's not just that they didn't divorce, but we have to see what is their behavior, what is their consciousness when they're together. How do they behave? Do they speak nicely to each other, or do they just argue all day?
We not only look at them whether they are together, but also look at their behavior.
Do they help each other remember Krishna?
他们是否能够帮助对方想着 Krishna?
Are they both engaged in Krishna's service?
他们是否都在从事着对 Krishna 的服务之中?
That is the real purpose of household life, family life, that you help each other to remember Krishna.
这是真正的 household, 就是这是真正的居士生活，他们是否在帮助着对方想着 Krishna? Sorry, Gurudev, I made a mistake. This question is how the Bhakti Yoga see their couples this well to get be together life and lifetime. Many lifetimes get together.
Many lifetimes?
生生世 lifetime and lifetime and lifetime get together. They want to swell in kind of, they want to swell, internally get together, the couples.
Lifetime after lifetime.
Yeah, they want to be together with each other.
That is not possible.
How do you?
That is not possible.
Yeah.
That's not going to happen.
这是不可能的，这是不可能的。Okay. Next question from Zhen Zhen. 半神人处于善良属性吗？Is the demigod are all mood of goodness?
Yes. Generally,
是的。
The demigods are in the higher planets. In the higher planets, the people there are all more in the mode of goodness, less passion and ignorance.
通常情况下，半神人他们是处在高等的星球，他们高等的处于星球之中，大多数处于情况下是善良属性。
You live in the city, that's a place of passion. And if you live in the bar, or the casino, or the brothel, that's a place of ignorance.
如果我们在城市之中，我们是在激情属性之中。如果我们是在sorry, I didn't know this three words. Boring, no?
Casino, 赌场。
哦，如果我们在赌场。
Or a bar, 酒吧。
酒吧，我们在酒吧赌场。
Or a brothel, 妓女的地方。怎么说？
Okay, 如果我们在酒吧赌场或妓院的话，这是愚昧属性。
嗯。And the countryside is generally considered the place of goodness.
通常情况下，乡村是处在善良属性。Then she asked, 他们是主的 Krishna 奉献者吗？超越三种属性还是处于善良属性？ Are the demigod, are the devotee of the Lord Krishna?
Yes, they're all devotees, but they have some material desires.
他们是主 Krishna 的奉献者，但是他们有一些物质愿望。
They get attached to sense gratification.
他们对物质感官享乐有一些依附。
So it's difficult for them to go back to Godhead.
所以对于他们来说很难以回归守身。
From the heavenly planets, it's almost impossible to go back to Godhead.
在天堂星球上是 from the
heavenly planet
很难以回归守身从天堂星球
but from the earth planet from this planet is not difficult
但是从这个地球上是很容易回来是不难以回去的
we have a short life we don't live very long
我们的生命不是那么的长
So we should take advantage of the short life, short time. You go on the higher planets, you live a long time. And then it's difficult to go back to Godhead. But on this planet, we live a short time. It's very easy to go back to Godhead.
我们在这个地球上虽然生命很短但是很容易回归守身。在天堂星球上生命非常的长而且不容易回归守身。
So we are very fortunate to get the human birth. in this planet.
我们在这个地球上非常幸运的能够得到人体生命。
Just after Lord Chaitanya came.
而且刚刚就在主 Chaitanya, 就是主 Chaitanya 刚刚还来过。
So we can chant the holy name and get all perfection.
我们可以唱诵主的圣名，得到所有的完美。
Never come back to this world of birth and death.
再也不要来到这个世界上，重复着生和死。This devotee of Lord Krishna, demigod, can they transcendental the three modes of nature, or they just stay in the mood of goodness?
Yeah, they just stay in the mode of goodness usually.
通常情况下他们只是处于善良属性。
And when they're finished all their piety, then they come back, they take birth down here on this planet.
当他们花完他们的虔诚活动之后，他们回到这个地球上。
And then they do more pious activities. If they come back here and do more pious activities, then they end up going back to heaven.
他们再回到这个地球上，再继续做虔诚活动，他们又会回到天堂星球上。
So they do that many times.
他们重复做这样做了很多次。
Up and down.Up and down.
上去下来，上去下来。
They never get free of birth and death.
但是还是没有摆脱生和死。
Okay.
Okay. Next question from Chaitanya Charan Prabhu. Hare Krishna, 礼拜古内，感谢帕布。灵魂高于智性、心意、感官。那灵魂能强迫智性和心意感官去作为吗？ Hare Krishna obeys to Gurudev. The soul is higher than the intelligent mind and the senses. So can the soul force the intelligent and the mind and the sense to do something?
Yes.
是的，可以。
If the soulhas a desire, then that desire of the soul will be taken by the intelligence.
如果这个灵魂有愿望的话，它可以带着这个智性。
So intelligence is seated close to the soul. So the soul has that desire, then it will help.To purify the intelligence and the mind and the senses.
智性就在灵魂的旁边待着，它很靠近灵魂。当灵魂有这个愿望的时候，智性、心意、感官就都容易受到净化。
The problem comes if we become contaminated, if our senses, mind, and intelligence become contaminated by lust.
但是问题就在于，当我们的智性、心意、感官受到色欲的污染的时候
，so then the senses, the mind, intelligence may not take direction from the soul. They may not listen to the soul.
当智性、心意、感官受到污染的时候，他就不再听灵魂的话。
So we have to be very strong in sadhana to control the mind and the intelligence, to keep them controlled.
因此我们要有很强的 sadhana 去让心意感官能够得到控制。Next question from Yuna. Now all the varna are mixed and a person can perform well the activities of different varnas. Does it somehow change in the case of a devotee? So can a devotee perform service according to the different varnas? 现在所有的 varna 就是社会的社会这个阶层是混合的。当一个人可以很好的从事他不同的，一个人可以从事不同的 Varna 的这些活动。
Yes.
但是 ，Yes. 嗯。
嗯，但是，你还没解释。
但 ，Yeah, yes. Does this somehow change in the case of the devotee? 在这种情况下，是否可以，是否会，是否对奉献者会改变呢 ？Somehow change in a case, 对奉献者有一些改变呢 ？Can a devotee perform service according? 一个奉献者可以根据不同的 varna, can a devotee perform?从事这个奉爱服务吗
？Yes, he can. Devotee can perform devotional service in any of the varnas, and he can change from one varna to another.
嗯，奉献者可以在任何不同的 varna 里面可以改变，是可以改变的。
According to the situation, just like Parasuram, he was born as a Brahmana, but he became a Kshatriya.
这个是可以不同，可以改变的，根据不同的情况。就像 Parasurama, 他本来出生在一个 Brahmana, 但是后来成为一个 Kshatriya.
And Vishwamitra, he was a Kshatriya, and he became a Brahmana.
Vishwamitra, 他本来是一个 Kshatriya, 后来又变成一个 Brahmana.
So a devotee for the service of Krishna, sometimes he will clean the toilet, sometimes he may cook, sometimes he may preach, he may do whatever's necessary for the service of Krishna.
因此奉献者为了取悦 Krishna, 为了满意 Krishna, 有时候他会刷马桶，有时候他也会去烹饪，有时候他也会去传教，一切为了取悦 Krishna。
Devotee will not say, "I'm a Brahmana, I don't clean." No, devotee will do whatever's required for the service of Krishna.
有一个奉献者不会说，因为我是一个 Brahmana, 所以我不去打扫马桶。但是一个真正的奉献者，他会做 Krishna 需要他去做的任何事情。
Yes.
Yes. Next question from Chandra Vinasi, Madhaji. 请教Guru，我想用世俗的一些话题引用经典的师姐给予Vasudev老师讲解的解决方案和解决他们当下的问题给予一些建议，这样制作收费10元左右的视频在互联网上去推广，主要是让更多的人唱诵 mantra。这样引用经典的做视频是否冒犯经典？感谢 Guru. I want to ask Guru. I want use some material topic, and then I use some sastras words to teach to my Vastu teacher, and.Solve some problems, also give some suggestions. I want to do some these kind of videos and share in the internet. My purpose is want to attract people to chant Hare Krishna, to chant mantra, to chant mantra. But it, can we do this kind of?Video, can it will offend the sastras?
Well, you have to be careful. You know, a lot of these mantras will be very difficult for ordinary people to chant.
这样的一些曼陀罗对于普通的人来说是不是那么容易去念诵的，不是那么容易去唱诵的。
Just we know in the Kali Yuga there are no qualified brahmanas who can perfectly recite mantras.
就像在卡利年代，不是有那么多有资格的 brahmana 去唱诵曼陀罗的。
You know, you cannot perform yagyas because there are no brahmanas here to do like animal sacrifice or horse sacrifice, because the brahmanas cannot recite the mantras perfectly.
就像在卡利年代，我们是不被允许做这个动物祭祀，因为我们的 brahmana 不是那么的有资格去念这个 mantra。
But anybody, everyone can chant the Hare Krishna mantra and get benefit.
但是每一个人可以唱诵 Hare Krishna mantra 得到净化，得到利益。
So we really want to propagate the chanting of the Hare Krishna mantra.
我们真的想去，希望人们去唱诵 Hare Krishna mantra.
Lord Chaitanya chanted the Hare Krishna mantra everywhere.
主 Chaitanya 在每一个地方唱诵 Hare Krishna mantra.
He didn't teach people to chant a lot of mantras, you know, other mantras, but mainly his preaching was the chanting of Hare Krishna.
他在传教的时候不是说用的别的 mantra， 他主要是 Hare Krishna mantra。
So,
I think the Chandra Vinasi Mataji, the main point she want to ask, she want to do some video, but video is a material topic, but she want to use some words from the sutras, and she want to ask whether this kind of video will offend the sutras.Because this topic is the material topic.
Well, I don't know. I don't know what benefit there will be. You put some mantra in there. You know, the point is, in this age, we want to give people the holy name of the Lord. That's what we want to give.
我不知道你的这个用意是什么，但是或者说这个结果，但是在这个要点是在这个年代，我们希望能给予别人圣名。
And if people hear the holy name of the Lord, then they get benefit.
如果人们听到圣名的话，他们会得到益处。
But if they just hear some strange Sanskrit mantra,and they don't know the meaning, they don't understand anything, they're not going to get benefit.
如果他们只是听到一些曼陀罗，他们并不能受益。
We want to think how to benefit people.
我们想的是如何让别人受益。
And Lord Chaitanya made it very easy to benefit people. He gave them the holy name. Tell them about Krishna.
主 Chaitanya 让这个事情变得简单，让人们只是唱诵 Hare Krishna. Okay, next question from Shyama Rajini. Shyama Rajini David Dasi. Hare Krishna, 顶拜 Guru Lake, 顶拜翻译。怎样才能让奉献者满意 ？Hare Krishna faces to the Guru. How can make the devotee satisfied?
How to make the devotee satisfied?
Yes.
Well, ultimately, everyone will be satisfied when they take full shelter at the lotus feet of Lord Krishna.
通常情况下，奉献者满意于 when we take full shelter of Lord Krishna.
Yes.
当我们全然的托庇于主 Krishna 的时候，奉献者会满
意。You want to be fully sat. You want devotees to be satisfied. We will never be satisfied with sense gratification. The only thing which can satisfy us is devotional service.
我们永远不会被你想让奉献者满意，我们永远不会被感官享乐满意。
We have to.
我们只有在奉献服务上面才会感觉到满意。
So if you're able to engage people in devotional service, that should satisfy them.
如果你能让人们从事于对奉献服务的话，这样可以满足他们。
Just like when they come to your house, your husband will cook some very nice posada, and they'll be satisfied.
就像如果有人去到你的家里，如果你的丈夫做一些普沙的话，他们会满意。
Because eating Krishna prasadam is very satisfying.
因为吃 Krishna 的 prasadam 是非常令人满意的。
So hearing about Krishna, chanting the names of Krishna is also satisfying.
唱诵、聆听主 Krishna 也会非常令人满意。
Engaging, giving people the chance to do some devotional service is very satisfying.
让别人从事一些奉爱服务也会令人感觉到满意。
So you just keep trying to satisfy people.
因此你努力地尝试去满足他人。Next question from Amy. How does Bhakti Yoga train those partners who have made aspirations to be together for life? Oh, I think.
这个问题问过了。
有问过了，问过了。OK.
对，我就翻给你听一下。
OK. Next question from Hari Vamsa, 顶拜 Guru. 我家 Gopa 现在一岁四个月了，感受到培养奉献者。标准孩子的辛苦，父母双方都要付出很多的时间，因为是把他当奉献者来对待。但世俗的朋友会让我们多生一个，不然孩子会孤单。他们都把孩子给爷爷奶奶来照顾，我们应该怎么办 ？Obeisance to Guru, our Gopa now is 1 year and 4 months. I and we all feel.Is very difficult to cultivate a devotee child as a devotee standard, and the parents will pay a lot of time because we treat this child as a devotee. But our friend, material friend, always suggest us to have more child.Because this Gopa will be very alone. He may feel alone. And our friend, they give the child to the grandfather, grandmother. So what should we do?
Well, I don't think you want to give your child to your grandfather or grandmother because they're not devotees.
我相信你不会把你的孩子给你的爷爷奶奶去照顾，因为他们不是奉献者。
You put your child in their home or with them, it will damage the child. It will not be good for your child.
你把你的孩子放到爷爷奶奶那儿，这会害你的孩，就对你的孩子不会好。
But if you want to have another child, that's up to you. You have to decide for yourself. Now in China government, they give permission, you can have 2 children.
Now it's 3.
Huh? You can have 3 now?
Yes.
Oh, very good. So you like, of course. It's not easy bringing up children.
对于你是否要多生一个孩子，这个取决于你。现在中国政府都开放3个了，这个还是你来做决定。当然，我也知道养一个孩子是有一点不容易。
But it's a very important service for Krishna.
但是这是对 Krishna 的一个很好的服务。
You're helping Krishna in the process of creation.
你在帮助 Krishna 创造。
But we need quality children. They have to be very nice. You have to bring them up. You have to conceive the child exactly according to religious principles, and you have to bring the child up to be a nice devotee.
你得按照伟达的这个经典，不仅在生育他之前做好这个宗教原则的准备，而且同时要按照经典很好的去抚养他们。
Don't become a father and mother unless you can deliver your child from birth and death.
除非你能让你的孩子解脱于生和死，否则不要去当一个父母。
Yes, any other questions?
Yes, yes. Next question from Tejas. 顶拜灵性导师，我正在努力开设狗文达素食超市连锁，请问他们读狗文达的圣名与读 Krishna 圣名效果一样吗？别人会问狗文达什么意思，开始我们只能隐藏告知是崇高文化共达彼岸的意思，这样可以吗？ A basis to Gurudev. I'm trying to have some the supermarket of the Govinda vegetarian supermarket. So when they chant the name of the Govinda, it's the same effect of the chant the name of the Krishna.
Yes, definitely.
是的，是一样的。
The holy name.
And, 是一样的，都是圣名。And when they chant the, when they ask what's the meaning of the Govinda, at first I explain to them, I explain them is the higher culture, and we go to the, go to the other side. Is that okay?
No. not very good.
不可以。
You should tell them go means the senses.
你告诉他们 go 是感官的意思。
Go and Vinda is the master or the controller, protector of the senses.
Vinda 是控制者、享受者。对于感官保护者。
Because people all like to eat meat and fish and eggs, so they're controlled by their tongue. But when
因为人们总是喜欢吃鱼肉蛋，所以他们总是被他们的舌头所控制。
So Govinda is the controller of the tongue.
Govinda 就让我们控制我们的舌头。
So tell them like that.
请这样告诉他们。
And you can tell them go can also mean cows.
你也可以告诉他们 go 是母牛的意思。
And you can tell them there was a person, and you can tell them about Krishna, you can preach to them.
你也可以告诉他们有 Krishna, 你可以向他们传播。
It's the name of a cowherd boy in a village.
这是这是在村庄的一个牧牛童的名字。
And he had many cows.
他有很多的母牛。
He's very famous.
而且他非常的有名。
So like that, you can tell them many things. Tell them the truth.
告诉他们真，诚实的告诉他们，告诉他们真理。
Okay.
And yes, I think the last question. Also from Chandra Vinasi, I want to ask a Guru, the Krishna's incarnation, the man mantra incarnation of the Krishna is also the holy name.
Yes, the holy name is also the Lord Krishna comes in the Kali Yuga in the form of his holy name.
主 Krishna 在卡利年代以他的圣名的形式到来。
We say Kali Kali Nama Rupe Krishna Avatar. That in the Kali Yuga, Lord Krishna comes in the form of his holy name.
在卡利年代，主 Krishna 以他的圣名的化身、圣名的形象前来。
Lord Krishna is a covered incarnation. He doesn't come in the Kali Yuga, right? He covers himself. Lord Chaitanya is a secret incarnation.
在这个年代，主 Krishna 遮盖了他自己的这个化身，而主 Chaitanya 是他隐秘的化身。
But the holy name comes for everyone.
但是圣名来了，为每一个人。
So we want to propagate the chanting of the holy name.
因此我们想传播圣名。
Lord Krishna has many names, of course.
主 Krishna 有很多名字。
We say Lord Rama, you can chant also the name of Lord Rama. But three names of Rama is equal to one name of Krishna.
你也可以唱诵主 Rama 的名字，但是 three names of Rama is Krishna.
And 1,000 names of 1,000 names of Vishnu is equal to one name of Lord Rama.
一千次主 Vishnu 的名字是一次 Rama 的名字，三次 Rama 的名字是主 Krishna 一次的名字。
So one name of Krishna is equal to 3,000 names of Vishnu.
因此，一次 Krishna 的名字相当于三千次主 Vishnu 的名字。
So we encourage people if you can chant. Of course, you can chant also Govinda. Govinda's name is also like the name of Krishna.
当然，你也可以唱诵 Govinda. Govinda 也是主 Krishna 的名字。
All right. So thank you very much for all the questions.
谢谢大家所有的问题。
Moment Ganshir Subhuti Rai Gewoman Jintai Dufan E Ganshir Sura Dufan Shenza Mingtian She Ekadese Woman Jufu Ne Mingtian Haho Nin Song Srila Prabhupada Ki
Jai
Go back to Vrinda Ki